Juliet Nanfuka has been hemmed into silence in the village of Luetamo. She keeps a Bible by her side to comfort her from the shock of the nature of her son's death. Her son, Hussein Walugembe, torched himself in the corridor quarters of Masaka's police station after negotiations to release his motorcycle turned futile. He'd been keeping two jobs before his death, a motorcycle rider and a cook for the Masaka police station. After the shock, Nanfuka has never spoken again. Walugembe had asked his friends if he passes on to give his mother 10,000 shillings as his final gift. Herbert Sekabuza, a police officer in charge of Family Protection Unit at Kamengo Police Station in Impiji, is an uncle to the deceased. He explains how his nephew got a job of a cook at Masaka Central Police.
Yafuna favor mu basirikale kubanga empisa ze tezibadde mbi n'akatono. Basolo mwagala nga siriiwo kuba abadde mwana muto emyaka gibadde mito. Namuleka nga tanaweza emyaka 18. Nina afuna favor mu basirikale olw'empisa ze ne basobola okumwongerako omulimu okuba nti afumbira abasibe.
Relatives are still demanding for justice for the death of the deceased.
Mutufu yafiridde mu bulumi atenga yafiridde mu mikono gya police atenga abadde ye mwana abadde awerera baganda be mutufu tusaba tufune obwenkanya eri mama wa Walugembe Kusanyu kubanga asigazza baganda ba Kusanyu abatalina buyambi.
There are still looming allegations that police officers sought to extort a bribe from him before his death. Police is, however, investigating the facts around the case. The motorcycle has already been handed over to the relatives of the deceased. Walugembe added to a growing list of Ugandans who have died in the enforcement of curfew and COVID-19 public health regulations.
Nga biri basobola okutuwa picha eno ne bagikwasa nnyina agireete kubanga be basobola okugigula ye ne mutabani we so baagimukwasa mu butongole ku poliisi e Masaka.